Today our topic is population geography and its scope and nature. According to the Tiwatha, population geography is concerned with the understanding of the regional differences in the earth covering of people. John A. Clark suggested that population geography is mainly concerned with demonstrating how spatial variation in the population and its various attributes like composition, migration, and growth are related to the spatial variation in the nature of place. Wilbur Zelinsky defined it as a science that deals with the way in which geographic characters of place is formed by and in turn react upon a set of population phenomena that vary within it through both space and time interacting one with another and with numerous non-demographic phenomena. R.J. Pryor suggested that population geography deals with the analysis and explanation of interrelationship between population phenomena and the geographical character of place as they both vary over space and time. In Tiwatha's opinion, an analysis of world population pattern, population dynamics in terms of mortality and fertility, area aspect of over and under population, distribution of population by the world region and settlement type and migration of population both international and internal regional form an important part of analysis in population geography. Quality of population and their regional distribution, he suggested that two broad groups, physical qualities, that is race, sex, age, health, and socioeconomic qualities, that is religion, education, occupation, marital status, stages of the economic development, customs, habits. Population geography studies the formation of the population in different territories in terms of structure, density, specific clustering, cities and rural communities, and the conditions that determine the particular form of settlement. The main concern of the population geography revolves around the following three aspects of the human population. Number one is that is size and distribution, including the rural urban distribution of the population. And number two is population dynamics, that is past and present trends in growth and its spatial manifestations. Components of population change, fertility, mortality, and migration. Population composition and structure. They include a set of demographic characteristics such as age, sex structure, marital status and average age at marriage, social characteristics, that is such as caste, ethics, religious and linguistic composition of population, literacy and level of education, attainment and economic characteristics such as workforce participation rate and workforce structure. Natural population geography receives important primary data from demography, which reveals the geographic aspects of natural and migration population change. Population geography also uses field term for observation and investigation. It studies the physical form of inhabitants, type of the residences, according to the spatial differences, the nature of planning and engineering for populated points, and so on. Because all of these features are reflected in the regional characteristics of the physical map makeup of cities and rural settlement. The location of population both throughout the country and within its regions, and the territorial organization of the population, and basically determined by the nature and the geography of production. The population density of individual population points is usually related to their national income function, and the population density of region reflects the degree of their economic development. At the same time, the establishment location of population exert in the turn an influence on the geography of production. The natural environment influence on settlement occurs primarily throughout production. It can be seen that the study of population is multidisciplinary in nature, involving an understanding of biology, genetics, mathematics, statistics, economics, sociology, cultural anthropology, psychology, politics, geography, medicine, public health, and ecology.